So it's been several days since this horrific incident with Israel and Hamas. And we have all seen that the actual death count is about 1,200 Israelis dead, confirmed, as of, I don't know, 10, 12 hours ago. And that includes babies and adults, elderly, young, toddlers, you name it, 1,200, period. Overall, it's about 2,000 and change. Half of them have been wounded, 1,200 confirmed dead. Not one program, not one conversation, not one issue about gun control here in the United States. It's funny how now everybody has forgotten that the cartels, the gangsters, the thugs, illegals, and anyone who has obtained an illegal weapon, who is murdering Americans and committing crimes here inside the U.S., not one report, not one program, not one news report, right? I wonder why. Because the fact that even Netanyahu said that they will be easing restrictions and allowing a decent portion of the population to now get armed to prevent this kind of crap proves that the Second Amendment is and will always be above reproach. Nobody's talking about it because the minute they open the fat, loud mouth, guess what's going to happen? All you have to look is back at Israel. That's 1,200 people that, granted, not all of them would have been properly trained, but if they had the means to defend themselves, they would have been able to very easily at least prevent that 1,200 number to go a little bit smaller. It would have been enough to put up a fight. And this is coming from the Israeli government. They were going to give them weapons to defend themselves. This is just to show you that gun control and their BS is exactly that, BS. And now, once again, if this crap moves into the U.S., we will prove why the Second Amendment is where it is. And it should defeat completely any argument about this lie about gun control and gun violence. It will prove once and for all why it was put there in our Constitution to defend from foreign and domestic enemies. Do you hear it? Listen closer. Not one peep about gun control. Stay frosty, people.